Hi, my name is Bintu, and in this Android lecture, we'll learn how to read the latitude and longitude of the user from the real-time database of the Firebase and display the coordinates of the user on the Google Map in the form of a marker, right? The question is, why you require such an app? See, in the last lecture, we learned how to store the user's location onto the Firebase real-time database in the form of latitude and longitude. See, you must have seen the Ola and Uber app, right? Where you see where the driver is moving, how close the driver is coming to our place, right? So in the earlier lecture, what we saw is that the location of the driver was stored in the form of latitude and longitude on the real-time database of the Firebase. This is a user's app. We are accessing the latitude and longitude from the Firebase and displaying it in the form of the marker on the Google Map. So the user can see where the driver is moving and how long it might take the person, the driver, to reach us. Not only for Ola Uber app, we can even use this application to track our relatives, friends, where they are moving, how close they are, in which direction they are moving. So let's start how to read the data from the real-time database and use it in the Android app. Let's start.
In this lecture, we learned to read the coordinates from the real-time database, right? In the last lecture, we learned to write the latitude and longitude into the real-time database. These were the coordinates, latitude and longitude, okay? Now we'll read this and we'll display these coordinates on the Google Map in the form of a marker. These are the coordinates of Qutub Minar. Let us assume that these are the coordinates of the driver, which is moving, right? So our app, when we run, I'll run it my phone. This is my Xiaomi phone, right? So I'm running it. And what is happening on my phone will be visible through this LogCat window. So my app is running and let's recapture. See, this is showing me the location of Qutub Minar, right? Can you see that? Now let us assume that the driver is moving and these are the coordinates of Agra. I'll change the coordinates 27.1751. I'll change it to 27.571. Okay. And what is the longitude of Agra? It is like 78.0421. Okay. Now see, in the LogCat window, this is recapture. See, it is showing me the location of Agra. So the coordinates are red. See, whatever the changes have been done on the real-time database, those coordinates are red and displayed on the Google Map, right? And this is the code for this. I'll make you understand each and every line in detail. So watch the video up till the end. So let us start. So the first step is to launch Android Studio. This is Android Studio. And we'll select the start a new Android Studio project. Because through this project, we'll be reading from the database file. Because we'll be displaying the location read from the real-time database on the Google Map, we'll be choosing this Google Maps activity. Select next. Passing the name of the project, let's give the name as, say, displaying location app. Okay. And let the minimum SDK by 19 by default. And the language selected is Kotlin. We'll select finish. In the lecture 13th, we learned how to integrate Google Map with Android app, right? Exactly the same steps we follow. We'll be requiring the Google API key here also. So we'll follow the same steps. Control and click here. We are navigated to the Google API console to fetch the Google API key, right? It is asking you to either create a new project or select an existing project for the Google API key. Okay. So I'll select any of my existing project and click on continue. I don't want to create the Google API key freshly for this project. I can use the earlier existing also. It is giving me this button, create API key. I'm selecting this button. This is the Google API key that I get, right? So let's copy this. It is copied. Let's go back to the project. Here, I replace this your key here by the copied API key. See, so I've got my API key. I'll go to my project. This is my maps activity, right? Now, the first step is to connect my this app with the Android real-time database from which I have to fetch the data. from which I have to fetch the coordinates of the driver, right? So I'll go to the tools menu and select this Firebase option. I'll get this Firebase assistant window. Because I want to connect with the real-time database, I'll select this option, real-time database. You'll get this link, save and retrieve data. Click here. It's asking you to connect with the Firebase. So click here. Now you should remember the app through which you were writing into the real-time database, right? Because from the same database, you have to fetch the coordinates of the driver or your relative or friend. So this was the app through which we wrote into the real-time database, information display app. We'll click here. Your Firebase Android app has been created in Firebase. Click on connect. Your Android Studio project is connected to your Firebase Android app. So it is done. Let's go back to the project. See, so you get this connected checked out. That means this Android app is connected with the Firebase. The next step is to add the real-time database to your app. So click this option. It is saying that to the project level build.gradle, this class path has to be added, right? Secondly, it is saying that this plugin and this dependency has to be added to the build.gradle of app, right? So if I click on accept changes, these all three things will be done automatically, right? So I'm clicking on this accept changes button. So class path, plugin and dependency all will be added to my build.gradle files. See, I am minimizing this assistant. See, it is syncing also. My project is getting synced with the changes that is being applied to the build.gradle file. It's done. I'll go back to assistant. See, these two are checked. Now it is asking you to configure your Firebase database rules. So I'll go back to the Firebase console. console.firebase.google. This was our app, information display app, right? You can see the two apps written here. That means the app through which we wrote into the real-time database and the current app through which we are reading from the real-time database, both are connected to this project, right? So I'll go to now database. See, this is the user location child node. And in this, these are the two coordinates, latitude and longitude, which are written using the earlier Android app. And this will be continuously written into the real-time database. The earlier data will be overwritten. That is, the way the driver moves, the new coordinates of the driver will be overwritten. That will be written into this real-time database. And from this database, we'll be reading and we'll be displaying on the Google Map through the app that we are creating in this lecture, right? And this is the code through which we'll be reading. Okay, so first step is to create a class. And the name of that class will be location logging. That class will be having two attributes, latitude and longitude, because these are the two attributes that we want to read from the real-time database. Okay, so we'll go back to the Android Studio. And here on this package, com example displaying location app, right click on this package, click on new, click on Kotlin file object class, give the name as location logging to this class. Okay, and double click on this class. And here, copy this class. So this class is ready, because we'll be reading from the real-time database using the object of this class. So this class is mandatory, right? Now we go to the maps activity. And in this maps activity, we have to write down this code. Let us start with these two lines. We are creating an object database ref of database class of Firebase, right? This database ref will be the object of this reference class of database class of Firebase. And this database ref is defined as a global. See here. So what is this database ref? It is an object of database reference class. And this database reference is a subclass of Firebase, right? So this database ref is pointing to this database reference class, and you are associating a value event listener to this database reference. What will happen with that? That is, if any event occurs on the database, if any changes occurs onto it, this event listener will activate, will execute, right? And this is the interface. This log listener is the interface. Basically, this value event listener is an interface. We are creating an object log listener of this value event listener interface. Now this value event listener has two methods which this class has to implement. What are those two methods? One is onCancelled and another is onDataChange. This onCancelled method is executed if the app is unable to establish the connection with the database or is getting an error while reading from the database, from the real-time database. And this onDataChange will execute if some data is changed in the real-time database of Firebase. In the onCancelled method, you are simply displaying a method that could not read from database, because this method depicts that there was some error reading from the real-time database. But if some data changes in the real-time database, this onDataChange method will be executed. That means the driver is moving and the coordinates of the driver are being written into the real-time database. In that case, what happens? This is the parameter data snapshot. This data snapshot is an object of data snapshot. It will be an image of what changes are being done on the database. Okay. So you are doing what? You're checking if the data snapshot exists. You'll go into this if method, right? This if method is from here till end, right? And in this, what you're doing? You are accessing the user location child. Recall that in the real-time database, you made a child node by name user location. And what you're doing that you are accessing its data using the location logging class. Recall that location logging is a class having two attributes, latitude and longitude, right? So what you're doing, you're reading from the child user location, and the reading will be done using this class location logging. And this location logging in lowercase is an object which will be carrying the data read from the real-time database. So this location logging will be having two attributes, latitude and longitude. And obviously these two attributes will be having the data read from the real-time database. So what you're doing, that latitude read from the real-time database will be assigned to this driver lat variable. These are the Kotlin variables. And this longitude read from the real-time database will be assigned to this driver long variable. Okay. Now what you can do, that you can display these two data on the console and close the application, right? Through this log function, right? But no, I want to display the location read from the real-time database on the Google Map. Okay. So what I'm doing, that I'm checking if the latitude and longitude read from the database, if both are not null, what you're doing, you are creating an object of class letLNG. This is from the 13th lecture, right? In which we learn how to display a marker on the Google Map. Okay. So you are making a driver log object of letLNG class, in which you are sending these two attributes, the data read from the real-time database, that is the latitude and longitude read from the real-time database. And you are creating an marker options variable, which is pointing to this driver log, right? And driver log is having the coordinates read from the real-time database. And if you click that marker, it will display a driver. You can write driver location completely, no problem. And by this method, add marker, you are displaying the marker on the Google Map. This M map is pointing to the Google Map, right? And you are animating the camera to that location. This animate camera will make the marker appear at the center of the Google Map. Okay. This new let long zoom is for applying the zoom effect on the Google Map. This 10F is for the city level zooming. And if you want the street level zooming, you have to make it 15F. Okay. And just to confirm that reading from the database was successful, you are displaying a toast message that location is accessed from the database. So let's do one thing. Copy this whole area. First, we'll copy this global variable. Copy, and we'll copy it here as a global variable above onCreate method. And here we'll read this two variables. One is your database reference and another is a listener to it. Okay. And what you want is that you have to display if any changes occur on this event, on this. So you copy this and paste it here. Let's close the assistant. You need to copy this dependency into your build.gradle. Okay. So copy this dependency into your build.gradle. Here, after this, paste it here. And don't forget to sync it. It's required. Done. Okay, remember that this site will help you in knowing what are the latest dependency versions. See, this site I'm showing you. developers.google.com/android/guides, right? And it will show you the latest dependencies, right? Because if you are not having a latest dependencies, your application might crash. Okay, so our project is almost ready to run. I'll just remove these errors by hover on the, this is red, right? So I'll hover onto it and click on import. This will become black because the library is imported here. See, database reference is included here. Firebase is giving you an error. Click on import. Library will be imported. Value listener, import. Click on import only. That's it. So all the, you know, libraries will be imported as a header. All done. Okay. Now I won't run this app on the virtual device. I'll run it on my phone, actual phone. Okay. So I'll connect this. Here you can see that my device will appear. Xiaomi Redmi device has come. I'll click on run. I'll make it zooming of 15. This is the street level. And what I'll do that I'll go to this. I'll change this coordinate to 27.1751. 27 point. And the coordinate of longitude I'll make it 78.0421. 0421. These are the coordinates of the Agra, and the zooming will be done at the street level. Okay, let's see what my app will do. Okay, so I'll open the logcat to show you what's happening here. Internet should be on, right? The street level zooming of Agra, Kachpura, Mehtabagh, and even if you want to see the Qutub Minar. These are coordinates of Qutub Minar, right? So this is confirming that my project is working very well. Last, let's try Qutub Minar coordinates. 28.5245. 27.1855. 8855. 855. Now, let's run again. Recapture. Mehroli, Seth Sarai, Chhatri. You can see it. Mehroli, Archigal Park. So you shifted to the Qutub Minar location, right? So my app is working perfectly well. If you followed my lecture, kindly subscribe to my channel, share the video with your friends, write your comments. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.